This week on Lights, Camera, Vegas, we're ringing in the new year with a look at the exciting new attractions hitting Vegas, plus an extra spicy edition of the Vegas Hot List. And speaking of spicy,
free your magic at Magic Mike Live.
Magic Mike Live not only has a new headlining home, but a new series is celebrating the Vegas production with a revealing new reality show.
People are going to be surprised how deep it is.
Then, ooh la la, we're brushing up on our French for the new season of Emily in Paris and getting all the scoop from the cast and the show's connection to Vegas.
We even have our own little Eiffel Tower.
I know.
I honestly feel like Kemi, Mindy, and Emily would have a blast in Vegas.
What are the chances?
Then Nick Carter is breaking Backstreet Boys news as the guys get ready to reunite. And we're back with all the entertainment fun as Lights, Camera, Vegas starts now.
Lights, Camera, Vegas, and Happy New Year. We're joining you from the newest property on the Strip, Resorts World, which is celebrating 2022 with a lot of exciting new additions. In fact, our entire city is celebrating a lot of new things, sure to make Vegas shine even brighter in the new year.
Katie, Carrie, even Garth, and the Piano Man himself will be spending time in Vegas in 2022. Joel will be marking his first ever stadium show in Vegas this February at Allegiant Stadium, home of the Raiders, which will also be home to some serious rock that same weekend as Metallica joins for a musical double feature. But the year kicks off with another first as we say hello to our newest headliner, Adele. The 15-time Grammy winner will be spending weekends at Caesars Coliseum for a residency that's broken all kinds of records. Katy Perry plans to play more in Vegas with her newly launched Resorts World residency, which is a colorful celebration of this California girl's classic hits. From playful pop to country music, Carrie Underwood and Luke Bryan are bringing Nashville to Vegas in the new year, along with one of the biggest superstars of all, Garth Brooks.
Garth Brooks returns to Las Vegas with one of the most memorable one-man shows in history.
The Thunder Rolls in February with Garth's weekend of shows at the Park MGM. Vegas will also feature the biggest party in country music, once again hosting the Academy of Country Music Awards in March.
It's John Legend, and I'm coming to Vegas.
John Legend is following his fellow voice judge Gwen Stefani to Planet Hollywood for his first residency. Oh, you know, we'll also get the smooth sounds of Michael Bublé for his series of shows at Resorts World. Will follow the beat to the Venetian, and our lips are sealed, but we're hearing comedy superstars will keep us laughing all year long. The Wynn is going all in with top talent like Sebastian Maniscalco, who'll play several shows throughout the year, followed by several other famous funny faces. And across the street at the Mirage, the Aces of Comedy keeps finding a full house of funny. So from humor to headliners, there's so much to look forward to in 2022. So let's toast to living in the most entertaining city that we're lucky to call home.
You're gonna do Paris for 1 year. For God's sake, do it right.
Ooh, that's a great question.
But while you're here, fall in love.
You just want something that's decadent and delightful and
that's
makes you feel good.
Ooh, yes. Decadent and delightful. Ooh, okay, girl. Okay, I'm writing that one down. Wait there, 2 seconds. Gotcha.
Hello. Hi, Las Vegas. Woohoo! And I've got the jacket, actually, that goes with you guys. I mean, I could be on one of your stages.
You got that new look. You got that new you.
It used to be so decisive. And ever since I moved to Paris, my life has just been chaotic and dramatic and complicated.
Oh, Emily, You're getting more French by the day.
I honestly feel like Kami, Mindy, and Emily would have a blast in Vegas.
We even have our own little Eiffel Tower.
I know. Yeah.
I love this series so much. It is so just delightful to watch. It has friendship and it has food and falling in love and fashion. But Lily, let me start with you. What do you think was the most fun thing or even more fun about shooting season two than the first one?
I think being able to be in more scenes with these women right here, because, you know, season one is very much, okay, we're establishing it's a show about this woman who moves to Paris, doesn't know much about what's going on, isn't immersed in the culture, is finding new friends, and therefore a lot of the storylines are separate. Whereas yeah. this season, they got to intertwine more and we all got to spend time together in the same locations, the same scenes, and kind of play off one another's energy more. And that was really fun because we all knew it existed offset. We just wanted to bring it on the camera. And so that was really fun this season.
The music and the show in general, I'm always thrilled when I'm watching these episodes and we're like, oh, what are these songs? Like all the French songs, especially. Yeah.
This is just such a huge mess. I can't just magically transform into someone who doesn't care.
You need to decide what you want and not what's gonna make everyone else happy.
Making my screen big is y'all handsome, so I want you like on a big screen.
Listen, how are you doing, girl?
Much better.
There we go.
Listen. I'm here in Las Vegas. My name is Rachel Smith. I had to go cover Magic Mike on Saturday and then talk to you guys on Tuesday. Kids, stay in school. Right? You guys, congratulations. First of all, I mean, I'll start with you, Lucas. I mean, the first season was such a delicious treat. I mean, when you came out for season two, were you like, how are we going to top this? And were you surprised how you did?
Oh, you like season two better? That's important for us to know.
Yeah, it's more of everything, more amore, more fashion, more fun, more friends. I love it.
Oh, great. Well, we're aiming for that. The show is just an explosion of love, romance, fashion, and bromance, and Paris. And it was so much fun shooting it, and I'm really glad you enjoy it.
I mean, so much. I mean, of course, season two is better, right, Lucien? Because you're in it too, the addition.
Listen, I feel so, so blessed and honored to be a part of season two. Honestly, season one, I was a massive fan of the show, and just to have this opportunity to work with this amazing, amazing cast and the writers, the directors and crew, it's honestly, I just feel super, super blessed to be part of it.
I've been to Paris and London, very lucky to do some traveling in my life. Have you guys been to Las Vegas before?
Yes, and it hurts thinking about it. Every time all the money I lost at the roulette, but you know, Vegas.
I've been able to come and watch a couple of fights out there. And yeah, Vegas is a very special place in my heart. And I can't wait to come to Vegas and meet you.
Anytime, we've got fights.
It's happening.
You've got the rest of your life to be as dull as you wish. But while you're here, fall in love.
And Sylvie, Philippine, I want to be Sylvie in my next life. She's the woman I wish I could be.
You can be her now. You don't need to wait for your next life.
Sylvie doesn't make apologies where she doesn't need to, and I love that.
Yeah, I agree. I love that too. I'm not like that really in life. I'm a bit shyer, but you know, she's teaching me a lot.
What would be a French phrase to describe season two of Emily in Paris?
How do you say eventful in French?
Je sais plus, mon chéri.
Plein d'événements. beaucoup de choses. Beaucoup.
I would say l'amour, c'est fou.
Voilà.
I need to explain myself.
The more you say, the worse it sounds.
Which is why I have to talk to her.
Ooh, that sounded desperate.
Kami, by the way, I just love that this show shows you that whether you're American or French or... The language of friendship is universal, don't you think?
Yeah, truly. I mean, friendship is friendship. Girls' gang is girls' gang. No matter where you come from, it's just a code, a girl's code that applies to every woman. So yeah, it doesn't make a difference whether you're American or French. Friendship between girls is friendship between girls.
Lily, let me ask you too, you know, the first season, the whole show is set up on, you know, your character takes a risk, leaves Chicago, and let me, and it pays off. What is the biggest risk you've taken in your career?
Ooh. That's a great question. You know, I think for me, I did a film a few years ago, probably longer than a few years ago, called To the Bone, which I was very, very proud of. It dealt with a subject matter that some people feel is untouchable to talk about or shameful to talk about. And it's one that I'm very passionate about speaking about more and communicating on. And I think that any film that discusses a topic that's a little bit tricky to talk about is a risk, but it's one worth taking. It's a conversation that's bigger than myself, and I was really proud to be a part of it.
Well, you should be, and you guys should be all proud of your performances. This is the show that just, I have so many girlfriends who are like, you're so lucky you got to see the second season. And I should have binged it so fast. I should have savored it, because now I want more.
Well, thank you. That's a good thing.
Hopefully we'll see you in Vegas. Come see us again.
Yes, well, nice, to see,
nice to see you. Bye, you guys.
Bye. Bye.
Still ahead, Backstreet Boy Nick Carter talks joining forces with other boy banders.
People are like, what is happening right now? This is like, this should not be allowed. This is crazy.
But first, think you've got what it takes to get on stage in your underwear? We'll hear from contestants in the new Finding Magic Mike.
Hey everybody, this is Nick Carter from the Backstreet Boys, and you're watching Lights, Camera, Vegas with Rachel Smith.
You are the husband that they never had. You are that dreamboat guy that never came along.
You know the movies. You know the live Vegas show. Now get ready for the latest chapter in Magic Mike Mania.
Does being sexy always hurt this much?
Finding Magic Mike is a new competition series on HBO Max, helping guys who've maybe lost their magic. Hosted by Adam Rodriguez, who starred in the films alongside Channing Tatum, he says the show is revealing in more ways than one.
The movies really set a tone for something. They said something, they were about something that was beyond just the sex appeal of it all. People are gonna be surprised how deep it is. Like, and it's really what we were getting after with the brand. And it's why we knew making this show was, you know, just had so much potential to move people, to entertain them, and to really to surprise them.
Absolutely.
So. I don't feel like the main character in my life anymore. I'm kind of here to rediscover my own masculinity.
So part of Magic Mike Live is being comfortable in less clothing.
A lot less clothing.
Everybody just take off your underwear. I mean, not your underwear, take off your pants! Oh, yeah, that's another show.
This whole message of like, helping men like find their magic again and be vulnerable and find power in their vulnerability was really cool for us. So the fact that we got to kind of use dance as a vehicle in a positive way with men that were willing to just, I don't know, put themselves out there, it was really cool.
It looks easy, it's not easy.
They're gonna crush it.
Two of the contestants, Johnny and Nate, were a little bit nervous about the show at first, but weren't shy in showing me some of their signature moves.
For the people out there, can you show me the Carlton?
Oh, yeah.
Come on, Johnny, come on, let's do it.
Are you ready?
Is there a science to it?
Yeah, I think it's the neck,
it's
maybe?
Like, it starts in the neck.
Lucky for us, they've got more moves than the Carlton and are just excited to be part of this magical new show.
It's a huge franchise to be a part of, so it's an honor to be a part of a franchise that's associated with Channing Tatum. He's like Hollywood royalty, so it's cool. Can you feel it?
I see magic in every single one of y'all.
We all heard about this third movie coming. Have you heard anything yet? I mean, are you ready if Channing calls and says, hey, I need the crew back?
I'm always ready. I mean, I may need a little time. I'm not ready to go tomorrow, but yes, if that call comes in, I'll always get ready in time. Yeah, without a doubt.
And there's no doubt, from the Vegas stage to the new show to the upcoming movie, the Magic Mike universe just continues to expand its orbit of sexy entertainment.
This is made for me.
One, two, three, magic!
Still ahead, Nick Carter says the Backstreet Boys are ready to reunite. He's got details of their tour that's about to begin. But first, a special Vegas hot list takes you deep inside Resorts World. The Vegas Hot List, brought to you by Pepper.
We start this week's Hot List at one of the hottest locations in Vegas. This is Pepper here at Resorts World. Like it sounds, Pepper is a spicy new addition to Vegas and a first of its kind luxury sexual wellness store on the Strip. This unique retail space is the largest at Resorts World and is the creation of husband and wife team Lincoln and Sarah Spohr. Pepper's concept is based on the five senses, and they have connection concierge to help guide your experience. From the cool conveyor belt to the secret corridor, there are so many exciting features at Pepper that will give you permission to play and will definitely get your heart racing. And along with Pepper, this week's Hot List looks at some other exciting spots you can find here at Resorts World.
Explore the secret speakeasy hidden right inside the famous Food Street Eats District. Just open the unmarked door near Miss Meow's and discover the intimate atmosphere of Here Kitty Kitty. Perfect place for some handcrafted cocktails and conversation. Also cool is all the art featured throughout the property, which is playful and fun. You'll find everything from lifelike ceramic donuts to a crayon sculpture to modern mosaics. And you can scan the QR codes accompanying the pieces to learn more about them. One of the biggest pieces of art is the 50-foot globe, a focal point of fun at the resort. It's a giant sphere covered in LED panels that change throughout the day, providing a perfect conversation piece as you shop or dine at one of the restaurants. Of course, one of the hottest spots at Resorts World is the new theater, where Carrie Underwood and Katy Perry have already kicked off their residencies, and where Luke Bryan and the Queen Celine will begin performing live there as well.
I'm doing so good. Thank you for having me.
Honey, so good seeing you. How's the holiday season going so far?
It's awesome. The kids are definitely bringing a lot of joy and spirit into the household. Watching them crawl around the floor.
Come on, bro. Let's go for a ride. We're going to Yellowstone. Oh my goodness, Kevin Costner's gonna be there.
So much joy in the household with the kids. So I'm happy right now.
I love that. I mean, because really, like, we talk all the time, and it's like every time you mention how you, Lauren, your family have just loved Las Vegas. You guys have really become part of this community. I mean, do you just love it? The more you live here, you love it even more.
Yeah, it's so funny because I was having these conversations a couple years ago, and I'm like, I don't know, how long am I actually going to stay here? Am I going to really love it? You know, like, maybe it'd just be a passing thing. And then I would hear stories from other people who had been here for like 30 years, and they said, yeah, we said the same thing when we first moved here, but we never left. And that's because you really know and you learn that this community is, I like to say, one of the best in the entire world. I mean, they're so tight. It's got a small town feel almost, yes. But at the same time, you know, everyone is trying to, you know, there's a life outside of the Strip, you know, and there's a community outside of the Strip that people don't realize. And I've been able to make many friends and learn about everything that Las Vegas offers.
Amazing shows in Vegas. I'm personally sad that you guys aren't playing here right now. It didn't work out for the holiday show, but you guys are going back on the road, back on tour next year, right?
Yeah, so we unfortunately weren't able to go through with the event, the show at the end of the year. We finished our album, finally finished it, the Christmas record, and that will happen at the end of next year. And maybe that residency will happen along with that at the end of 2022. But yeah, June, we start at the Hollywood Bowl in Los Angeles, and it's another 58 shows. So we're anxious to get back out on the road, and we're going to be jumping right back on our DNA World Tour.
You have been playing these fun shows with the after party with all the boy band mashups. Wow. of those next year?
Yeah, so I actually have made a lot of friends over the years, especially with the boy banders, the other guys who share sort of parallel lives and stories with me. Joey and myself and Wanye, actually, who lives in Las Vegas and from Boyz II Men. And all of their friends, you know, we basically did like a couple one-offs at the Venetian, and it was a lot of fun. We called the show The After Party, and it was, a lot of people were like, what is happening right now? This is like, this should not be allowed. This is crazy. Like all these different artists from different bands on the stage. So we had a lot of fun. What are the chances that we're in the place,
like two in a million, like once in a life? Some solo music coming out next year too.
I've been recording in Las Vegas a bunch of that new solo music, and it sounds really great. We're excited to launch that first quarter of next year.
It's been so exciting being in Las Vegas, because you could also just be, you know, a fan of all these great. Have you been hearing about all the new headliners that are coming to Vegas, like John Legend, Michael
Adele?
Adele. I mean, of all the new people who are coming to town, who are you most excited to see?
All of them are incredible. I think like Adele would be definitely number one for sure. But John Legend's incredible. They're picking very high quality talent.
Katy Perry, Carrie Underwood. I mean, yeah.
Absolutely.
I mean,
like, all of them.
We just got to get the BSB back on stage in Vegas at some point. I mean, we got to make that happen.
We got to get the boys back in town.
For joining us for the first episode of the new year, and get ready for even more celebrity interviews, show previews, and just a lot more fun to come on Lights, Camera, Vegas. Until next time, guys, I'm Rachel Smith. Take care.